Francis turbine tutorial question number 4. A Francis turbine is required to give 180 kilowatt output power under a head of 20 meters. Overall efficiency is 80% and the hydraulic efficiency is 85%. The turbine speed is 600 rpm. Flow velocity is constant at Vf equal 0.3 power square root 2gh, and the ferroperal velocity at inlet U1 is 0.8 square root 2gh. So this equation is only for this question. Please do not remember this equation, and it not suitable for all situations. This is only for this question. And there is also no whirl velocity at discharge. Discharge here means the outlet. Then determine the diameter of the runner at inlet, the guide vane angle, the runner blade angle at inlet, the width of the runner at inlet, assuming blade thickness occupy 15% of the circumference. From the question, what you need to do first is you need to draw the velocity triangle. And this is the velocity triangle. I hope you know to draw the velocity triangle for Francis turbine. We list all the parameters that we get from the question. So we have a lot of parameters that we need to list down here. And this is the equation for Euler head. It can be reduced into V whirl 1 U1 over G, because the value of V whirl 2 here is equal to 0. Now we are calculating diameter of the runner at inlet. The equation that have diameter and can be solved this problem is from U equal to pi dN over 60. We rearrange that equation, we could write down as d1 equal u1 times 60 over pi dn. And then, to substitute this equation, we need to know what is the value of u1. u1 can be calculated by using this equation. This equation is given in the question. So we substitute the value of h here with the h effective. And it is equal to 20 meters, we get U1 is equal to 15.84 meters per second. We substitute in this equation, we get D1 is equal to 0.504 meters. Next, we are calculating the guide vane angle. This is the velocity triangle, and the guide vane angle is this theta. From the velocity triangle here, we could write down tangent theta is equal to Vf1 over Vwall1. Vf1 can be calculated by using this equation. We substitute the value of h here with h effective, which is equal to 20 meters, and we get Vf1 is equal to 5.94 meters per second. And from the equation of hydraulic efficiency, we have this equation. We could rearrange this equation to become, to calculate Vwall1 here. We substitute all the value, we could get Vwall1 is equal to 10.53 meters per second. Now we are calculating the runner blade angle at inlet. This is our velocity triangle, and the runner blade angle is located here. From the velocity triangle here, we could write down the tangent beta 1 here is Vf1 over Vwall1 minus U1. Then, when we substitute the value, we find that the value of U1 is bigger than the value of Vwall1 here. So it means that the blade shape here is not a backward one. It should be a forward blade type. So it is okay not to change our velocity triangle here, but in our calculation, we must make sure that we subtract the bigger value with the smaller value. So the equation for tangent beta 1 here will become Vf1 over u1 minus Vl1, because the value of u1 here is 15.84, which is bigger compared to the value of Vl1, which is equal to 10.53. So we solve this equation, we could get beta 1 is equal to 48.2 degrees. The last one, we need to calculate the flow rate. However, in this question, the width of the runner at inlet, assuming blade thickness occupied 15% of the circumference. So, with this statement, we need to have the value of K. First, from the equation of overall efficiency here, P0 over rho GQH, we could calculate the value of flow rate. We substitute all the value here with the H here, the turbine head is equal to 20. And we could get the flow rate is equal to 1.147 meter cube per second. Then, to calculate the width at the inlet, the blade width at the inlet, we could use this equation. We play around or we rearrange this equation and we could get B1 is equal to Q over Vf1 K pi D1. We substitute all the value and please make sure that you substitute the value of K here is 0.85 because the blade thickness only occupied 15% of the circumference. So the idea to calculate the value of K is given in the previous lesson. So from this calculation, we could get B1 here, the blade width at the inlet is 0.143 meters.